He is highly sensitive. But his sensitivity is selective. Where it affects him, I will give you illustration, examples. Right. So generally, they pose us the question, have you read the book? And when we say no, they have a big laugh. They have a big laugh. Now for a change, you should ask them, have you read the book, sir? He says, no. And you are armed with this booklet of mine. You just memorize some of these statements, verses, and you quote him. He says, you know, sir, the first page of Satanic Salman, Satanic Verses. First page, chapter 1, page 1. He says, direct quotation I'm giving you. Direct quotation from the book, page 1. Don't go far. Start with page 1. You have been going too far. You know, you are going to page 268 and 300. Don't go that far. Start with page 1. If you have been reading, you can start with page 1. Even before page 1, you can start with his prologue, his prophecy about his own destruction. Not a place to rest his foot upon. No place for him. No peace. That's what he's saying. He's prophesying. Somebody is making him to write. So look, this is your end. This is your destiny. That's the first page, really. But he doesn't number it. So we take chapter 1, that page, first page. He says, proper London. This place here, London. Are you in London? Yeah, proper London. Bhai, here we come. Those bastards down there won't know what hit them. Which bastards? Londoners. You Londoners are bastards. Whether you are Pakistani Londoners or Sikh Londoners or English Londoners, what Londoners are you? If you are a Londoner, you are a bastard. And the things are coming down to destroy you. Direct quotation. Now, how does he feel? He said, look, he's calling us all bastards. You accept that? If it came from you as a Pakistani or as an Arab, the guy will punch you on the jaw. You know that? But this is a son-in-law. He married your sister, your daughter, a British girl. So you have to take it from him. No? You see, we people from the East, we seem to respect our son-in-laws, our brother-in-laws, more than our own children. You know that? Because he is my son-in-law, my daughter's happiness is at stake. He is my brother-in-law, my sister's. This is our mentality. Is that the English mentality too? I don't know. But they have some special feeling towards this satanic Salman. So he starts with bastard, very mild. But I said, wait a little till he gets warmed up. Let him get warmed up. That's first page that was. He uses, on that first page, 16 Hindi words. 16, 1, 6. For which he gives you no meaning. And you lap it up. I'm talking about the English now. The Hindi, maybe some Hindu. The other young people, what will they understand? Yaar, bhai. What will you understand? What is he talking about? Tum-tum. No. If I read it to you, you can't imagine. You can't imagine anybody taking this book up, paying £15, the fool. He pays £15 for this book, and he reads this. I read the first paragraph. See what you make of it. To be born again, sang Jibrail Farishta, tumbling from the heavens. First you have to die. Hoji, 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 hoji. The Englishman understands what he's saying. Hoji, hoji. To land upon the bosomy earth, first one needs to fly. Tata, takatum. The Englishman laps it up. Very nice, very nice. What? Indian spice. Still the paragraph is not finished. How to ever smile again? At first you won't cry. How to win the darling's love? Mister, without a sigh. Baba, if you want to get born again, just before dawn, one's winter's morning, New Year's Day, or thereabouts, two real, full-grown, living men fell from a great height, 29,002 feet, towards the English Channel, without benefit of parachutes or wings, out of a clear sky. And this is a masterpiece of the English language. Yes, for which gets a Booker Award. He gets a Booker Award for that. And he carries on 16 words. And by the time I finish it, I said, you know, this guy here, he spattered the whole book over 100 different exotic Indian words. And the choices of the language from the gutters of Bombay, or the sewers, you know, sewer pipes from the sewers of Bombay, page 80. He says, hijras, chutias, shits. The Englishman, I want to know, what is he lapping up? He's telling the guy, hijras, chutias, shits. Now, do you understand shits? So he senses, the other thing must be also something smoothie. What does he know what he's reading? And these poor fools, the French will translate that into French with hijras, chutias, shits, and the German will hijras, chutias, shits, and our Jewish brother and cousins in Palestine, in Israel, they, in Hebrew, they will write in Hebrew, and they'll say, they'll write hijras, chutias, shits. Shits, of course, they'll have the word for it. What are they doing? This guy has made a monkey out of everybody. Look, he's a mighty genius. He's our own. We produced him. But the British cultivated him. His godfathers, protectors. You know, I can't even translate this. I can translate it, I know the meaning. Bulk of you think you know the meaning. You really don't know the meaning of what he's saying. Very few, very rare. What he's getting away with. We should ask the Penguin publishers, sir, do you know what he's saying? You haven't translated, he hasn't given you a glossary at the end of the book to tell you this word means that this, nothing. He doesn't do that. He doesn't do that. He's getting away with murder. But nobody show it to our fellow countrymen. So look, this guy is making a monkey out of you, sir. Look what he's doing to you. We must ask the Josephine Pauline Thompson of the General Secretary of the Penn, you know, the society of all these essays and editors and writers and playwrights and all that kind of thing. They have a society called Penn, acronym for all these things. Michael Foote and the Booker Prize Committee. Ask them, what is this for which you paid this guy $800,000 or pounds? I don't know whether it's dollar or pound, but it is $800,000, all right. As advance money. He said, this shit, don't give another printer. We will have this. We will eat this. That's what they did. Advance money. He said, look, this is for us. Reserve it for us. He's made monkeys out of everybody. And he got money in the process. He's our product. He's a mighty genius. Now, if you say that the British are insensitive, I say, no, you are wrong. They're not insensitive. I'm reading in my country, call for ban in our local newspaper. It's dateline from London. The news comes from London into our newspaper there. Call for ban, banning a person. Furious British MPs, I'm reading. You'll find this on page 9 in your book. Don't take it out now. Leave it now. Furious British MPs have called for American actor Mickey Rourke, to be banned from Britain. Harry Greenway, Conservative MP for Ealing North, said, I hope the British government will never allow this man to set foot on our shores.